All right, so for all whole numbers and polynomials, we can write them so that they can be written as product of prime numbers for numbers, and polynomials can be written as product of irreducible polynomials. This is known as the fundamental theorem of arithmetic when we're dealing with numbers, or fundamental theorem of algebra when we're working with polynomials. So our observation is that any integer or polynomial a is a multiple of b if and only if all factors of b are also factors of a. For example, 6 is a multiple of 2 because all factors of 2 are also factors of 6. Let's take a closer look at this. So all multiples of 2 must be of the type 2 times something. So 2 times 3, 2 times 2 squared, times 3 squared. So 2 times pretty much anything you want. 2 times x, 2 times x plus 1, 2 times all of that. All of these are multiples of 2. Why? Why should I say these are all multiples of 2? Because all factors of 2 are also factors of these quantities. All right, why don't you write down some examples of multiples of 3x plus 4? Remember, if it's a multiple, it must look like 3x plus 4 times something. So pause the video here and note just a few examples of multiples of 3x plus 4. We'll give you a few moments. Assuming you've come back from jotting down some ideas, take a look. We can write anything we want pretty much, just as long as you have 3x plus 4 and then something. 3x plus 4 times x cubed times 3x more copies of 3x plus 4, number multiplied by numbers or different polynomials. As long as you see 3x plus 4 in it, that's going to be a multiple of 3x plus 4. Okay, so let's take a look at this. X is not a multiple of x plus 1. How come? We see x right there. How come x is not a multiple of x plus 1? That's because we cannot write that as x times something. Anytime we write x times anything, if you have x term in it, it's going to be x squared. So we can't write x plus 1 as a product of x and something else. So x is an additive factor of x plus 1, but not a multiplicative factor of x plus 1. Therefore, x is not a multiple of x plus 1. So, in other words, a quantity A is only a multiple of another quantity B if and only if what? B is a multiplicative factor of A. So, A is a multiple of B if B is a factor of A. Remember that. Multiplicative factor, not additive, just multiplicative factor. Keep that in mind, drill that in your head. All right, let's look at some examples. Why don't you spend a little time deciding, is this quantity here, this big number that's written here, is this number a multiple of that number? Spend a little time thinking about that. How can we decide that? Well, we can't multiply the numbers, they're too big. So how can we decide if this number is a multiple of that? Remember what it means to be a multiple. That means all of these factors should be in here. So we'll have to start comparing. Let's start looking at 2. Well, this one has a 2 in it, this one has a 2 in it. But are there enough 2s? That's the most important part. So here we have a power of 2. So the only way this number here is going to be a multiple of that number is if this power is 2 or more. If the power of the 2 here is 2 or more, then we're good to go. And are we? It's a 4, so yep, check mark there. All right, let's take a look at 3. Here we need power of 4. So 4 or more power, this is a 10 power, so yep, that checks out, so we're good to go. Let's take a look at 5. 5 squared, power must be 2 or more, and we have 2 exactly, so that's good. Now, this one has an extra factor of 7, which is okay. You can have lots of extra things as long as all of these quantities, all of these factors appear here as factors, then this first number is a multiple of the second number. All right, let's look at this next one. This number is not a multiple of that number. Why not? Let's start checking. Okay, 2 is present in both, so we need power of 2 or more. We have power of 4. That checks out, doesn't it? Yep. All right, let's look at next one. Both have 3s. This one has a power of 5, so we need 5 or more. This one has 10. We're good to go. They both have 5s. Oh, there's a problem. See, here we have 6 power, so we need 6 or more power here, but we only have a power of 2. So that's not enough 5s. We don't have enough 5s, so that right there makes it not a multiple. This number here is not a multiple of that number here because right there. But if you look at the next number also, they both have 7s. Power must be 12 or more, and we only have 3. So there's another reason for why this number is not a multiple of that number. Look very, very carefully and understand why this is not a multiple of that number. All of these factors have to be present here. We only have 5 squared. We need 5 to the 6 or more and 7 to the 12 or more, and they are not present here. Okay? How about that? Can you explain why this is a multiple of this? Well, we have to do the same thing we did with numbers. Start checking factors, right? We have x minus 1 here. We have x minus 1 here. The power needs to be what? 2 or more. And we have power of 4 here. So that checks out. Next, x plus square root 3. X plus square root 3. We need power of 5 or more. We have power of 19. Nope, good to go. We have x's and x's, power of 3 or more, and we have 3 or more, and it all checks. So every factor here is present here in one way or another. We may have more stuff, but as long as minimum, all of these need to be here. And if that's the case, then we are good to go. All right. How come this is not a multiple of that? Well, we have to go one by one with each factor. So let's look at x minus 1. X minus 1 is present in both. We need power of 4 or more, and we only have power of 2. So here we have power of 4, here we have power of 2. So nope, not good enough. We need 4 or more x minus 1s multiplied together to make this a multiple of that. So that's alone right there. It fails. But we could keep looking. This one works out. 2 or more power. And x is completely missing. So nope, no hopes of that being a multiple of this term here. Okay, so in order to be a multiple, each factor has to be present. More stuff can be there, but you should have at least minimum of all the factors here need to be here. Try these on your own.